Previously on Guardians of the Galaxy.
You don't know a lot about me, but before I met you guys, there was someone. She's gone now, but maybe with that relic I can make her ungone.
I know you've got a lot on your mind, but that kid you fought, maybe he does too. Promise me in the future you'll use your words instead of your fists.
I will, Mom. I promise.
Thank you, baby.
The Eternity Forge resides here, pending such time as it can be wielded responsibly. Until then, she shall remain entombed across the galaxy.
Come find me, Peter. I'll be waiting for you. You're nearly there, Peter.
I got it, Mom.
Thanks, baby.
Another headache?
Just a little one. Stop worrying. It's fine. Just took me by surprise.
I wish I could help.
I know you do. Some things, Peter, they're not yours to control. I better get that prescription before the pharmacy closes. Stay out of trouble till I get back, okay? Be good. I know that's not always easy for you.
No dice, Mom. You gotta love me for who I am.
Oh, I do. Sometimes against my better judgment. I'll be back soon.
Hey, Pete.
Hey, Mr. Pinkle.
Here to get that mixtape copied?
Yeah.
Sure is a nice thing to do for your mom. How's she doing, anyway?
She's not doing so well.
I'm sorry to hear that, Pete. Well, I'm sure this is gonna make her feel a lot better. Music's got some powerful mojo. Both sides? Come back in about an hour, and it'll be ready.
Hey, Petey! You make that mix for your boyfriend?
I made it for your mom.
Watch it, or you'll be swallowing your own teeth. Afraid I'm gonna break it again?
You afraid I'm gonna hit you again?
Listen to you. Pretending you got balls. Hey, how's that lip doing? Give me that. What are you doing here anyway? You don't have money. Everyone in town's talking about it. Your mom can't even pay her medical bills. She's been going door to door asking for help, like some pathetic loser. She's probably off looking for change in the sewers right now. Yeah, maybe she'll get lucky and find a quarter.
Come on, let's not do this, man.
Do what?
We're just talking.
You gonna cry now? Huh?
You done yet? Elephant ears? You must get great reception with those things.
Nah, I'm not done. But your mom?
She sure is.
My dad goes drinking with her doctor. Told him everything. Guess she didn't feel like it was important enough to tell you. Oh, check it out! Dead woman walking! What's the point? Drugs ain't gonna help. My dad says you're gonna die anyway.
Where'd you get those bruises, huh? Your dad? Or does your mom have a good swing too?
I'm gonna go to your funeral just to see your son cry.
Get out!
My dad's gonna-
Out! You kept your promise. You didn't fight that jerk. I'm proud of you, Peter. Even though I didn't set a very good example. The things he said. I let my emotions get the better of me.
You slapped him? That was awesome.
No, that was not awesome, Peter.
He said you were dying, Mom. Is that true?
Find me, please. You're so close, Peter.
What the? How did I get home? Gamora? Sorry, I didn't catch that. This temple is really messing with my head.
Hit again!
What'd you say? Hello, Gamora!
Ah!
Whoa! Hey, Gamora!
Come on,
what?
Nebula.
What are you doing?
You can do better than that.
Not Nebula! It's me, Peter, who you like a whole lot and definitely do not want to kill!
Come on, this isn't fair! I don't have a sword!
Nebula. You need to be aware of everything around you. Perception's just as important as strength and speed.
None of them are important when I'm stuck here. I want to use what you've taught me somewhere outside of this room. I'm sick of just doing the same thing over and over, every single day.
I know you think you want this. But once you've taken a life, there's no going back. Thanos will make you kill again and again, and pretty soon that's all you'll be. A murderer.
At least I'd be something.
Ah!
Looks like you've lost your touch.
Hardly.
A little impressive.
Just a little.
I can't. Gamora, you're hurting me. Father!
Nebula, you have grown so much.
Father.
You may yet be the greatest assassin in the galaxy. Don't you agree, Gamora?
I do. She's come a long way.
What a pleasant surprise. Perhaps being bested by your sister recalled the importance of humility. I have a mission for you. You will go to a Kree outpost on the planet of Phalion. There you will find General Tarval. He has come into possession of something I require, a device. Gamora. You will fetch the device for me. You, Nebula, you will kill the General.
Thank you, Father. I promise you, I will succeed.
I know you will, daughter. Gamora, you were always my favorite, but you have become cold. Distant.
Father, I don't think this is a good idea. Nebula isn't ready. She's impulsive, reckless.
Do not question my judgment. You have lost any confidence I had in you. Go and prepare. You will head out immediately. And Gamora, I know you no longer care, but if you fail, your sister will pay for your missteps. Tell Nebula I wish to speak with her.
Is everything all right? What's going on? I couldn't hear you, but Father, he didn't look happy.
Thanos wants to talk to you.
To me? Yes, this is it. My chance to prove myself. Or fail miserably.
Don't worry, Nebula. I've got your back.
No. I've got to do this myself. It's what I've been training for. I won't let Father down. Let's just do this.
Thank you. Nebula! Nebula, are you all right? Are you hurt?
Why? Why did you do that?
What?
I had him. That was my kill and you took it from me! Father will be so upset with me.
I won't tell Thanos, I promise. We'll keep it to ourselves.
Give me the device.
Nebula, what are you doing?
You took my kill. Give me the device in exchange. Give it to me, now! I'm not asking here. Do it!
No, that's not how this works. I don't take orders from you.
Then you leave me no choice.
What are you... You slapped me!
I was trying to snap you out of it before you killed me!
Well, that's not the way to do it.
Well, apparently it was! Stop! Stop slapping me! Stop it! Okay, Uncle!
Don't do that again. I don't know what happened. One minute you and I were walking into the temple, and the next I was...
Yeah, I know.
Wait, were you... Did you see all that? My memory?
Are you okay?
I've been trying not to think of that day. Because I really want to fix things with Nebula. But seeing that... She thought I was being selfish, taking away everything she worked so hard to achieve. That's why she turned on me.
She tried to kill you. There is no excuse for that. Look, if anyone deserves to hold a grudge, it's you.
That's not how Nebula sees it. That last moment, it became everything. All I remembered of her. But there were times we were happy. Despite Thanos, despite everything, we had each other. Maybe I could have done more. Been more honest with how I was feeling. Stop just seeing her as someone I needed to protect.
You can't change the past, Gamora. She is who she is.
That's exactly it, Peter. Nebula is who she is because of me. That hatred, that coldness, her inability to trust anyone. She is Thanos' daughter. Who else could she be after I betrayed her? I failed her.
I'm worried about you. You keep thinking stuff like this, it's gonna drive you crazy. And we've already got enough crazy on this team.
This is true. Thanks, Peter.
Now, come on. Let's figure out why the Forge brought us here before things get even more. Weird. Oh, man. My mom loved this song. She played that record non-stop.
Peter, wait. This place, it seems to be using our memories against us. We don't know what we'll find inside, or why it's been drawing us here.
Yeah, well, if anything goes wrong, you'll be here to protect me, right? You're not saying anything, and it's super worrying. Gamora, seriously?
Do you recognize this place?
Yeah. This is where my mom... This is where I saw her last.
I don't know what all this means, Peter. But I hope somehow you get your mom back.
Thanks for, for understanding.
She's your family. Your real family. I know how much she means to you.
Thank you.
are you?
You have known me for a while now.
Not your mom, right?
Definitely not.
You came for me. After all these... Ooh, what are these? They're very shiny.
Hey, over here.
Peter Quill. You're really here. It's been centuries. No, millennia.
I came here expecting to find my mom.
I can explain.
Nice reflexes.
Let me try that again. May I borrow that? Your gun. It will only be for a moment.
Yeah, that's not gonna happen.
Very well, then.
Didn't see that coming.
It is so wonderful to be free of that tomb. No longer trapped in my own mind. Alone. You are truly the hero the legends foretold. So brave and handsome. Though, perhaps not in the classical sense.
What?
Ha!
You must have many questions for me.
Why were you locked in here?
So that you could find me.
Not very helpful.
I have been waiting for you all this time. The moment you touched the forge, I knew you were the Celestial One. That you could free me. So I reached out to you the only way I could, through your memories. The ones most vivid to you. But you must understand, I had no control over them. Oh no, that is not what I wanted at all. I am so sorry. I truly did not know you'd feel so violated. I'd hoped you would feel glad to see her again. I did not mean for my abilities to hurt you.
How?
Your mind is clouded with so many emotions, so you seek answers. But those answers will not help you.
How could you possibly know how he feels?
I can show you, Angry Lady. Oh, no. Never mind. May I show you? Please, I mean no harm. Watch.
Do it again! Come on!
With great pleasure!
Oh, this isn't going to go well.
Oh!
What emotion was that?
I do not believe I should say out loud. Sexual. You see, I am an empath. I can read the emotions of others. It is my duty to help the Celestial One decide the fate of the Forge.
That could really come in handy.
Oh, she's got to meet the rest of the group.
Yeah. Introduce an emotionally charged being to a group who are emotionally sensitive. Who should we try on first?
I got just the one.
This tree man has profound love and affection for everyone in this room.
I am Groot.
Oh, not everyone. Some of you he has mixed feelings about. He is pleased that someone can understand his true feelings.
Mantis is an empath, Groot. She can sense your emotions. She's also the one who made us relive our memories.
That was you? We went halfway across the galaxy, got chased by that psycho Hala for a party trick?
It is my job to guide the Celestial One.
What the hell does that mean?
The Celestial One?
You messed with our minds. Why?
She thinks I'm someone called the Celestial One. How about that?
Celestial what?
Why is there only one? And could that one also be me?
Oh, I can explain. Long ago...
Wait. Are you gonna spew some long mumbo-jumbo about where you come from and why I should care?
Yes. Is that a problem?
Remember Thanos? Going on like, now that I got this, I'm gonna roll through the galaxy like a giant turd and blah, blah, blah.
Well, I, for one, want to hear it. All of it.
Then it's time for a nap.
Go ahead, Mantis. Enlighten us.
Of course, Peter Quill. I have communicated only through my feelings for years. It is nice to communicate with my mouth. Eons ago, the Eternity Forge coalesced into existence as a way to balance the life energy of the universe. To create, you must destroy. And to destroy, you must create. But such colossal power cannot be wielded lightly. So I was brought in to ensure that the Forge was only wielded by someone deserving, and to help guide the wielder down the right path. But I waited. And waited. Years went by. Many unworthy tried to use the Forge. Some even tried to force me to help them. The Kree decided that no culture had matured enough to use the Forge with the wisdom required. Eventually, the Forge and I were separated, locked away until a time when civilizations could reach the peak of wisdom and maturity.
And that is only the beginning.
Well, thanks a lot for that, Pete.
What an interesting and relevant story. Aren't you glad we heard it all, champ?
Someday, Quill, I'm gonna blast you out an airlock.
I have not yet gotten to the most important part.
Kill me.
There is a legend of the Celestial One, the chosen one who shall arrive from the stars to use the Eternity Forge.
This Celestial One, what are they like?
Advanced intellect, emotionally mature. Wise being capable of navigating the dark waters of immense power. Someone who can see beyond his own selfish desires.
That describes me pretty perfectly.
Hey, come on, guys. Hey, knock it off.
It is not funny. Peter is the Celestial One.
Oh, you're so full of crap, lady. If Pete is this Celestial Watson, then why didn't the stupid Forge work?
Sure, it brought him back. But when we tried to use it again on someone else, it didn't do a damn thing.
Your loss. I can feel it has been with you for some time. The Forge is limited right now. It can only restore life to a body that is mostly whole and undeteriorated.
I am Groot.
Well, that explains Hala's delightful corpse collection.
She'll bring them all back if she gets the Forge.
Fantastic! So it's incredibly useful to our worst enemy, but useless to us.
It can be made more useful.
How?
The Celestial One must deliver the Forge to the sacred shrine. There you can unlock its true power. Or destroy it forever.
And that true power is what?
Returning anyone, from any time period, back to the realm of the living. Lost ones, loved ones,
I suppose hated ones, too, if you were so inclined, though I do not know why.
Why would I destroy the forge? This thing sounds awesome.
Hala!
Its awesomeness comes with a price. Life energy cannot be made. It must be transferred.
So someone still has to die for the thing to work.
And let's finish our drinks and go use this thing.
Yes!
Really? Who are you planning to kill?
Well, you're kind of annoying me right
now. Hala wants to use this forge to raise her army. We have to destroy
it. Not until my family is returned to me.
I am Groot.
Right? Groot says he's on my side. That's 3-1, Gamora. We win.
That is not true. Groot feels the opposite.
Maybe something got lost in translation. Hey, you try understanding I am Groot all the time.
I can't believe I never thought to ask this question until now, and it's terrifying me. Do you even understand, Groot?
Of course I do. I'm sorry, I just don't want that thing destroyed until we use it. It was a one-time thing.
I am Groot?
Okay, a two-time thing.
So, it is a tie then.
Two for using it.
I am Groot.
I'm gonna take a guess. He said two for destroying it.
Don't you get what this means? We can bring back anyone that we lost.
At a cost.
No cost is too high.
You got this.
Well, you'll have to make a decision soon.
Well, one way or another, this all ends at the shrine. Can you take us there, Mantis?
I have never been, but with your help, I believe I can sense its location. May we have some space to concentrate?
Gladly. If anyone needs me, I'll be emotionally unavailable.
And that's new.
Ha ha ha.
What are you doing?
Helping?
Maybe it is best if you sit still.
Right, of course.
I cannot sense the shrine. There is so much unrest among your crew. Their emotions are overwhelming me. They look to you for guidance. Help them.
Hey there, Groot.
Oh. Is that a friend of yours?
I am Groot.
I'll tell you this. We're all gonna be okay. No matter what happens with the Forge.
I am Groot.
Hey, bud. What's up?
Well, if it ain't Captain Indecision.
What are you?
I don't know what's holding you back from doing the right thing here, Quill. I mean, I can count on one paw how many folks ever get a chance to bring back someone they love.
I am Groot.
And what happens if Hala gets a hold of it, huh? This falls into the wrong hands, the whole galaxy is screwed.
The whole galaxy is already screwed. It's always screwed. You think if we destroy this thing, that'll make a difference? Ah, the only ones you're screwing are your so-called friends.
Rocket.
You know what, Pete? I wish the Forge had never brought you back. Yeah.
I am Groot.
It should have brought someone else. Anyone else back instead.
Lila would be ashamed of you right now.
You saw one damn memory of her. You're talking like you knew her? Go to hell, Pete. Only this time, don't come back.
I am Groot.
You can both go to hell.
Well, that's one way to clear his emotional unrest.
I am Groot.
Calm down.
Drax, how are you doing?
I was angry that you did not allow me to guard Nebula.
But that...
But now, I am hopeful. The Forge can bring my family back, if you choose to use it.
Well, I...
So I must trust you would not take away my chance to reunite with my wife and daughter. Even though you did not behave in a trustworthy manner.
Huh?
You used that antenna woman's powers without permission. It was wrong of you to do that. Even if the tree did not mind.
Come on, it wasn't that bad. Was it?
Our feelings are our own. They belong to us alone.
Yeah. I probably shouldn't have done it. I'm sorry. Bad taste on my part.
I am glad you are so apologetic. Though I do not understand how your mistake could taste badly. Her ability to see into our emotions. It must be difficult. I would not wish to know the pain of others as well as my own. Thank you for checking in on me, Peter. You may leave now.
Fine. 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 Fine.
Hey, are you okay? What the hell was that?
I tried to say everything I could think of. I thought maybe if I asked her to stick around for a while... Ugh, she won't hear it. Not from me. She'll barely even look at me.
That's just who she is now. You need to accept that.
I know. It was stupid to even talk to her. Nebula and I, there's no fixing that. We're better off apart. She can get on with her life, and I can get on with mine.
I think you're right. She shouldn't stay with us. Let her go somewhere else. Anywhere else.
As long as it's far from me. I'm done with her.
Hey, Nebula. Yeah, hey, it's me, Peter Quill, but you know that. You mind if I sit? Cool, yeah, this is really... How's the arm?
It's not bad. Would have come in handy to have both arms while fighting off the Kree. I suppose I'm lucky you let me out at all. So, thanks, I guess.
Like I said then, it was just a trust exercise. You passed.
Pretty sure Gamora still needs convincing. Speaking of my dear sister, bet you got an earful. What'd she say about me? That I'm a waste of space. That I deserve everything I've been through.
Actually, she told me how good it was between the two of you. I mean, at least before it all went sideways.
Yeah. There were a lot of good times, but they didn't last very long. Gamora doesn't even realize that she's the reason our family ended.
Yeah, well, that's not how it looked to me.
What do you mean?
When we were in the temple, I saw Gamora's memory of your last mission.
Oh, yeah? What did you see?
She saved your life from that Kree general dude. I mean, he would have killed you if Gamora hadn't stepped in.
No, he wouldn't have. You have no idea what really happened that day. And neither does Gamora. Not all of it, at least.
Then show me.
Now,
Please take my hand.
If this kills me, I'm going to kick your ass. Is everything all right? To me?
Nebula, my favorite daughter.
Father.
Your attacks against your sister were swift, precise. You disarmed Gamora easily. I was impressed. You should be proud to defeat an enemy of such caliber. There is something you must know about Gamora. She has told me that she does not believe you are ready for this mission. That you never will be. Every day, she grows more agitated and bitter as she watches you surpass her. You've seen her lack of respect. She disobeys me time and time again. I no longer trust her. You shouldn't trust her either, Nebula. Gamora has become a risk to our family.
I know she's been difficult, but Gamora won't fail you, Father.
I caution you to be careful with your sister. That is all I ask. If she continues to be a problem, you might take her place. Stand by my side as my greatest warrior and only daughter. Gamora makes herself more useless, more unreliable with each passing day.
It won't come to that, Father.
I'm not so certain. We shall see how things go on Phalion. This is your moment. Go and prepare. Keep your communications open. I'll be monitoring the situation.
Nebula, are you all right? Are you hurt?
Why? Why did you do that?
What?
I had him. That was my kill and you took it from me!
I won't tell Thanos, I promise. We'll keep it to ourselves.
Nebula.
Father.
You were wrong. It has come to this after all. I am done with her insolence. If you don't get rid of her, I will do it myself. Only I will ensure that your sister suffers greatly.
Give me the device.
Nebula, what are you doing?
You took my kill. Give me the device in exchange. Give it to me, now! I'm not asking here.
No, that's not how this works. I don't take orders from you.
Then you leave me no choice.
What are you?
Is it done?
What's going on? See?
It wasn't over.
She showed me your last mission together.
I tried to show him what really happened with Tarval, but you interrupted us. This is between you and me.
But you won't even try to understand.
And Quill is the understanding one? Ha!
Whoa!
She was always pushing against Thanos, testing his limits. What happened was her fault.
Yeah. I practically shoved that knife into my own back. Too bad I had such terrible aim. Some assassin.
Gamora, I wasn't trying to kill you.
Oh yeah? Then what were you doing? Because it looked exactly like you were trying to kill me.
She was just following orders, Gamora. Thanos made her do it.
It's true, Gamora.
What a load of crap.
I saved your
life! Admit it. You just wanted to prove you were better than me. By killing me.
If I wanted to kill you, you'd be dead! Thanos was going to kill you himself. There would have been nothing left of you. Do you know? I even checked your pulse, just to make sure you were still alive. You never got to see that part. The most important part. But I did.
That doesn't make any sense.
I'm kind of believing her here, Gamora. She hadn't fake killed you. I'm pretty sure Thanos would have been a lot more thorough.
Peter, no offense, but you're being an idiot. I want you out of my life for good.
And I just want to keep the only family I have left together.
You're calling us a family? After everything you did?
If you were listening to me at all, you might have heard I had my reasons.
Reasons sort of melts away when I look at the massive scar. Make that scars you gave
me. I was
me.
A child. I didn't know what I was doing half the time.
Nebula, I hate to say it, but I gotta go with Gamora on this one. We're gonna have to part ways.
Thanks for nothing, Ass Lord.
Okay, yeah, that wasn't necessary. Unless you meant it as a compliment, which...
I didn't.
Okay. Where are you gonna go? Nova Corps is gonna be all over you the minute you leave.
I've got some ideas.
Peter, I can finally sense the shrine.
Okay. Let's go.
Hey, Pete, I threw some mean words your way back there, and I wanted to apologize, you know. So, yeah, sorry about that. I got worked up, you know?
Hey, don't even worry about it, man. Best friends forever?
Yeah, at least until death.
It's close enough.
Also, such sadness.
You are a very nostalgic person.
Hey, whoa, what's the matter? Why are you crying? Why am I crying?
Oh, God. The little box brings you so much sorrow. Oh, God. I'm sorry for that. Sometimes emotions overwhelm me and reflect back onto others.
Yeah, it's cool. I'm cool. Okay.
Everyone on this ship is so poisoned by their feelings, overly focused on the past. Not living here, in the now, experiencing all the wonderful things around you.
But if we use the Forge, there are a few things about our past we can change.
That does not necessarily mean you should. You must have realized this by now, but if you bring someone back, It can never be as it was. Thank you for letting me listen to your music. It made me feel better and worse at the same time. I loved it.
Hey, Mantis? Can you direct me to that magic shrine thing now?
Of course! But it is a long way, and I must concentrate completely. There can be no... There can be no distraction...
I didn't know it would do that! Oh, you have made an awe-inspiring mess.
Distractions.
I'll see what I can do.
Yeah.
Entrance to the shrine. Skilled warriors, you can find great symbolism in much of their architecture.
Yeah, they like pretty things. We get it. Now what, Pete?
Mantis? Any pointers?
It appears the forge goes there, on the altar.
Seriously? Well, that was anticlimactic.
Relic in place. Check. Must be something else to it.
Hey guys, have a look around. See if you can find anything that looks off.
I am Groot.
Of course something's
anything?
Wrong. Because we're in a frickin' Creed temple, where everything is always more complicated than it needs to be.
Quiet.
I mean, ain't they ever heard of an on switch?
So, what now?
Repair the statues. Determine the fate of the universe.
Oh, is that all?
How do you know I'll make the right choice about the Forge?
I do not know that.
Oh.
You are the wielder of the Eternity Forge. It chose you. You must trust there's a reason.
Yeah, okay. No pressure at all.
There we go.
No. You were saying?
Hey, Rocket. Tell Groot I need some help with the lens thingy.
Okay, okay.
I am Groot.
Yeah, good job, buddy. That forge is gonna be resurrected in no time.
I am Groot.
He says you might destroy it. That he hopes you do.
Is that really what he said? One more to go. Something tells me it's not gonna be easy.
How's it going, Gamora?
In a few minutes, we're gonna have to decide the fate of the Eternity Forge.
Not we. You. For whatever reason, this is all in your hands. Look, I know you haven't really sided with me or taken any of my advice lately, but the Forge is dangerous. You have to make sure no one can use it. Ever.
Okay, let's see. This big guy used to stand here, holding up that giant whatever it is thingy. Then things go bad. Age sets in.
Oh no, I dropped it! Ah!
So where did it go? Well, we're about to seal the fate of the Eternity Forge.
Yes. Your decision will leave you despised by much of the team.
Good pep talk. Thanks, Drax.
No matter what you choose.
Yep, you can stop now.
What now, Celestial One?
This thing really took a hit when that lens smashed into it.
It might still be intact under there.
That's what I'm counting on.
Come on. Stupid jet boots overheated.
Drax, I need your muscles.
You cannot have them. They are attached to me.
No, I know they... I need your help. I've got to lift something very heavy.
Ah, I see. You are weak. I will help you. I am ready.
Can't quite reach. Hey, Rocket. I need you to grab that lens.
Getting crushed to death ain't on my list of to-dos, Pete. I'm sure if you just reach really hard, you could get it. Maybe dislocating your shoulder or something?
I cannot fail.
Please, Rocket, I need you.
All right. But I get smushed. I better be first in line for some resurrection. Never make me do that again. I had to crawl on all fours. It's degrading.
But there is still no statue upon which to set it.
You're welcome.
We did not thank you.
Ingrates.
Interesting.
No, it's not. They're just ingrates.
Yep.
I got this.
Oh, dang it. That's right.
Maybe I don't got this. Okay. Listen up. I need everyone over here.
Just a little higher.
My arms can't go any higher.
Your muscles are soft.
Shut up.
Guys, stop talking.
Like a baby's bottom.
Shut up.
Ow! That's my face.
A very fat baby.
Sorry. Hey, what do I know about whatever you are, anatomy? Maybe your people enjoy having their faces stepped. Drop this thing!
No.
These freaking temples. I'm gonna take dynamite to all of them.
Now it is truly time to decide. Turn the forge to the left to destroy it forever. Turn the forge to the right to empower it and bring it to its full potential.
Okay.
Wait, his right or your right?
Oh. I don't know.
What?
Let me see.
Wow. I can't believe that almost happened.
Turn it this way to destroy it. Turn it this...
Yeah, we got it. Turn it to the right, Pete.
It's left, Peter. You want your left.
Peter, you must turn it left.
No! It's right to empower you, idiot.
Oh, yes. Go right, Peter. I am Groot!
Destroying the forge is the only way we can keep it from hurting people.
I'm sorry. This thing is way too powerful for anyone to wield. We gotta destroy it.
Thank you, Peter.
You don't know anything about me, lady.
Perhaps she has never lost a loved one. She has only killed the loved ones of others.
Drax!
I am Groot.
Oh, yeah? And what would you know about it? You're a freaking piece of wood!
Process has begun. You can release it.
I am Groot.
You can't even communicate on your own. Think I like translating for you every single time?
I am Groot!
Now you're gonna start. Drax, back me up.
You are all
No offense, Drax, but wisdom isn't your strong suit either.
Guys, we got company!
Thank you, Peter Quill. I never could have found this shrine without you. And the tracking device Jinsar placed on your ship.
You know, I didn't think you could get more annoying than that time you killed me. You really suck.
Sister?
Nebula, what are you doing?
Why even ask when it's so clear you never listen? You or your precious Star-Lord.
Their usefulness has expired. Dispose of them.
Enough of this.
God, boots are more busted than I thought.
How you like me now, huh? No!
Perish to the depths, blue demon!
You want to make these idiots your family? You can die with them! You won't win. Watch me!
Just let go!
Stop the rodent!
Big blue lady. Not the first time. Intriguing. Will you let me have a minute? Sheesh. Now. Where was I? Well, that was surprisingly easy. Hang on, buddy, I got you!
Sorry to have made you sad.
You want to keep fighting? Fine. I'll just keep winning. Again and again. Until all that's left of you is one tiny, little piece. The only part of you that's actually worth something. I hate you! Ah!
friends are fools.
Come on! Work, damn it!
The Eternity Forge is mine.
Paula, stop!
Baldir, my son, come back to me.
No more.
Hope you're happy, Quill.
You did what you had to do, Peter.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess so.
Everything from me. I will destroy you and all that you love.
So now Mantis is tagging along, but she's only creating more questions than answers. About the Eternity Forge, about Hala, about everything.
Janitors of the galaxy, that's what we should be called. And Hala and the Kree, well, they're just the latest cosmic spill.
As much as he's wrong about almost everything he does, Peter was justified in his actions with the Forge.
She agreed with me? I mean, of course she did. Can I get a copy of her saying that?
It's what happened next that he should regret.